a bomber plane is moving horizontally with a velocity of 98 meter per second and the bomb released from it strikes the ground in 10 seconds. Find the angle at which it strikes the ground. Here the plane is moving horizontally with a certain velocity, 98 meter per second. In 10 seconds it is going to strike the ground. Our interest is to find the angle at which it strikes the ground. Nothing but angle made by the velocity vector with the ground are horizontal. So imagine this is a bomber plane moving horizontally, say with the velocity u. A bomb is released from it. So the released bomb moves along parabolic path and strikes the ground. This is the ground. So question is, at what angle it strikes? Nothing but angle made by the velocity vector here. So if I take this as alpha, our interest is to find alpha. If v is the velocity here, we know that tan alpha is equal to vy by vx. Vy is the vertical component of velocity, vx is the initial component. So in this figure, this becomes vx and this direction, this becomes vy. Therefore, substitution of these two can give us alpha value. What is vy? Horizontal projectile, vertical component of velocity after given time, gt. So your tan alpha is equal to gt. Here g 9.8, t 10 seconds, u is 98. So if I cancel the terms, this 9.8, 98, 10 times, 10 and 10 gets cancelled. So remaining is 1. Implies tan alpha 1 implies alpha is, that means bomb strikes the ground at an angle 45 degree. Here our interest is to calculate the angle made by the velocity vector with the ground. So if alpha is the angle made by the velocity vector with the ground, then tan alpha is equal to vy by vx. Substitution gives us the result. A fighter plane flying horizontally at an altitude of 2 km with a speed of 540 kmph passes directly over the head of an aircraft gun. If the gun can fire a bullet with a muzzle speed of 500 meter per second, the angle with the vertical at which gun should fire the bullet so that the bullet hits the plane. Here the fighter plane is moving horizontally with 540 kmph speed and when it is directly above the head of an anti-aircraft gun, the gun fires the bullet with 500 meter per second. We have to calculate the angle at which the bullet must be fired so that it can hit the plane. Angle with the vertical we have to calculate. So again imagine this is a flight moving horizontally, say with a velocity u. So on the ground, gun is mounted here. When it is just above, this aeroplane is just above the gun and gun fires the bullet. This bullet has to hit the aeroplane. So we know that bullet moves along parabolic path. So when the plane reaches this point, if the bullet reaches this point, then there is a possibility for hitting. Our aim is to calculate at what angle this bullet must be fired with respect to the vertical. This is my interest. At what angle we have to fire the bullet so that it hits. See here, the horizontal displacement of bullet as well as aeroplane, both are equal. Horizontal displacement from here to here, aeroplane travels, bullet will travel from this point to this point in the horizontal direction. So if I call this as x, x must be same for both. Okay, let v is the velocity of the bullet. Now x is equal to, for aeroplane it is u into t. If I assume bomb will hit the plane after t time, so x is equal to ut. Whereas for bullets, here vertical component of angle made with vertical is given, that is theta. If we know the angle with the horizontal, we can take horizontal displacement as u cos theta into t. Now the angle is given with respect to the vertical, therefore it becomes v sin theta into t, because in same time the bullet must hit the plane. So in this equation, time on both sides equal, therefore the velocity of the plane and horizontal component of velocity of bullet must be equal, then only it is possible for the bullet to hit the plane. So here u is given as 540 kmph, converted into meter per second, 5 by 18, 540 kmph, the velocity of the plane, whereas for muzzle speed of the bullet 500 meter per second. So this is equal to 500 sin theta. Our aim is to calculate theta only. This 540, 18, 30 times. Therefore, 30 into 5, 150 by 500 is equal to sin theta. So if I cancel 0 with 5, 5 threes, 5 tens. Therefore, our sin theta becomes equal to 3 by 10, or theta is equal to sin inverse 3 by 10. This is the angle at which the bullet must be fired so that it will strike the aeroplane. So here aeroplane moving horizontally and bullet is fired at some angle. The time of travel of aeroplane and bullet are equal, then only it is possible. So simply we can say the horizontal component of bullet velocity must be equal to the aeroplane velocity, then it is possible to hit. So this is the case. The velocity of the aeroplane u and horizontal component of velocity of the bullet v sin theta are equal. Here angle is given with respect to the vertical, therefore horizontal component of velocity is v sin but not v cos.